TheSmartLocal.com.
Okay, so this is the final episode of the Poly Food Hunt, and I brought someone very special to finish the season with. He is...
This is not Republic of the Philippines. This is... Woodlands!
Okay, so this is Julian, our head videographer. So all the cinematic stuff that you're gonna see today is gonna be from him. He does free stuff and he does free food even more. So we're gonna kill two birds with one stone this episode. We're gonna introduce him to you guys and we're gonna try out the food here. Okay? Okay, so earlier you were saying that the building all very nice, right? It is the newest poly, that's why the architecture and everything very nice. Oh, there we found our first place already. So we are currently at the Kofu, which is the south canteen, and basically we ordered the Yong Tau Fu, which was recommended, as well as the nasi lemak. It's only $3, so that's damn cheap. This one, right? I don't know why he take, right? But why is it $5?
So it's empty, so I keep adding stuff.
Julian, you know what you're doing?
No.
Your bowl is very full.
Is it? I guess that's enough.
Let's try the Yong Tau Fu first, okay? Considering that I don't really eat Yong Tau Fu with soup, right? It's quite pleasant, it's quite nice.
Yee.
The right, inside like powdery, right. Right. Yeah, very weird.
I like the taste of the wrapper.
The wrapper?
Yeah.
What wrapper?
For the dumpling, MC dumpling.
Come to the crab stick, to the chili.
Nice, right? It's like sweet and then got a kick from the chili as well. It's like a normal Yong Tau Fu. Nothing special. Okay, so before we try the next dish, Julian, fun fact about you. Go!
I used to make my own comics, so I have like a pile of them in the Philippines.
So next dish, nasi lemak. Let's go. I think the most important thing for me in nasi lemak is the rice.
Rice.
Right. Has the coconut taste.
It does, but I don't think it's very strong.
But it's not enough.
Okay, come. Now you must try with the chili.
Like every other chili out there.
The chicken, right, has a very strong turmeric flavor. It's not something that I would expect from a nasi lemak chicken, you know what I mean? This for $3 is quite worth it, and they give a lot of rice as well.
If I was studying here, I would like to buy all the cheap stuff. I would eat this.
I think the best thing about this store is actually the nuggets. That's I think right. Every poly, right, there will be one store, right? It's usually like a Malay store. Then they will sell nuggets in bags. Next location, we don't know where it is because we haven't been here before, but we're gonna find it and then we'll be there. Okay, so this place is called... fly! So this place is called TRCC and it apparently has the best food. Like a lot of people recommended the spicy chicken wrap, the iced milk tea, and... Wow, this sounds good.
Crab pasta.
Okay, let's go TRCC.
You know, it's chili crab.
These are the three items that were recommended. The iced milk tea is the most popular thing, followed by the chili crab pasta. You can either choose between different types of chicken or fish. It's $4, eh? That's insane, eh? We just try to drink first. It's like bubble tea, eh? It's like the bubble tea kind of taste. Like if I was studying here, right, I would actually come here just to get this. We go on to the rap. Julian, can you do a rap right now? Filipino rap. Let's go. And that was pretty good. I didn't expect you to start rapping.
Oh, okay.
I cannot take spicy very well.
What?
It's not bad.
It's nice.
Mm. It's almost like a KFC.
That's what I was about
to say. Like KFC chicken inside a wrap. Mm. Not bad, right? Mm. I mean, the fact that he took a second bite immediately, even and then he has this. So this is the thing that I'm most excited for because I love chili crab. Hey, the serving size also is quite decent.
The fish is nice.
Is it? There's not too much batter and oil. And also they marinate the fish itself very well. I don't know, I feel like the chili crab flavor doesn't fully do it for me.
It tastes a bit instant.
Yeah, that's exactly it. So let's go, Julian fun fact number 2.
On my first 2 weeks here in Singapore, I was homeless.
So you came here without any money?
I had to go here as fast as I can or risk losing the job.
Now he's here, eating free food. He started from the bottom, now it's here.
Here.
Yeah. Mm.
I'm awkward in front of the camera because
I've been behind for so long.
But I've seen you in some music videos before.
Don't link it!
Maybe right now is the perfect time to cut to a cinematic sequence by Julian. In 3, 2, 1. Okay, time to dig into bingsu.
Wow. It like melts in your mouth. Mm. And I don't know what this powder is, but it's amazing. It's also sweet.
Exactly the same as what you find outside, but half the price. So it's fantastic. I would suggest coming here just for this. You can read a book and have this, right?
Right. Like books about sailing. I'm ready to start sailing.
And of course you have this condensed milk, but slightly lighter version, right? Slightly more watery version, and it's extremely sweet, very very nice.
Oh no, it's falling!
Oh my god!
Let's just make it look good again. How about you try to eat the plant?
Okay, how about you try to eat the plant, since this is your first time.
Why would I do that?
Go ahead,
can't
just
believe
try.
I'm falling for it?
You're not falling for anything, just try it. I think the flavours will be quite good. I think you really got to chew to get the flavour out of the plant.
So nice, it's like Garden of Eden.
Two naked people running around sitting on most of the leaves.
It tastes like they're sweat. I think since it's a new food and I'm super amazed by the taste, I'm gonna give it a 10.
As Janice from Friends says, bing-a-ling.
My bing-a-ling.
Fun fact number 3. Share everybody what you do in TSL.
I am one of the head videographers. I mainly do client videos.
Like, is there a particular video that you're most proud of as of now?
Plus 65 Pulau Ubin episode. The last postman of Pulau Ubin.
So just before this, you already saw Julian's epic cinematics, right? Now, we're gonna show you his epic dance moves. They've got height elements eh? Have you tried anything like this before?
It looks dangerous.
But do you trust me?
It's very hard to trust someone to carry that much weight.
But do you trust me, Julian? Between me and Fauzi is that when I notice that people are like looking at me because they know me, recognize me on TSL, right, I'll be like, look busy, you know? But Fauzi is like, right, if somebody happened to just glance at him and he was like, hi, hi friend. We've just visited the lawn.
Take two.
So we've just got out of the lawn. We got the ayam penyet, we have the pad thai from the Thai store, and
crowded bowl.
So this is tomato and cheese pasta with the ball. The pasta doesn't have much taste, but the ball is damn nice. Based on the texture. It's mock meat, right?
Yeah.
This meatball is better than... Okay.
Real meat.
Yeah, it's better than real meat, eh. Okay, so this is the tofu slice thingy. I don't really like the texture of this one, but I think the flavor is quite on point.
It's like eating carton. Like wet carton. Carton boxes.
Wet carton? Isn't it cardboard?
Or cardboard. Yeah. But carton.
But wet. Maybe a different combination might have worked better for us.
refreshing.
So I'm mixing it up, and as I am mixing it up, I see only two pieces of cuttlefish and two prawns. I think that's pretty decent considering it's $3.
But I think it lacks some more ingredients.
Whenever you eat like something like pad thai, right? Mm. It has to have an explosion of flavors. You know, yes. Thai food, you have the sourness, the spiciness, the sweetness all at once. Yeah, it's a far simpler version of pad thai. So I would say this is just pass. Like, if you're craving pad thai, fine. And this is your only option, fine. It will suffice. Pad thai, away! And now I think this is the one that I've been most anticipating. Lontong sauce and gravy for the rice. Okay, like, it's a bit mild. I think the chicken here is very average. It's a bit dry, a bit overcooked. Okay, I think this one pales in comparison to the franchise Ayam Penyet that you can find in all the other polys. Most of the other polys.
I like the chili though.
Yeah, the chili. Okay, the chili is pretty good.
The rice and tofu is nice. Just that the chicken is a bit lacking.
Yeah.
On the taste department.
So now we're moving on from the lawn, and we're heading over to our final location, which is the North Canteen. But before we do so, Julian, fun fact number 4. What was your first impression of me in TSL?
Snobbish and not arrogant, but just snobbish and very curious about everything.
Julian, how do you feel this? And then, Julian?
Like, to the point that I don't want to talk anymore.
So, am I very far off from my first impression?
The vibe you produce is like you're very serious, you're unapproachable, but not really in real life. You're just very wacky and never serious, actually. Hi, excuse me. Are you Mala? Mala. Mala. Oh, this is Mala?
Yeah, Mala.
Oh, okay.
We are finally at the last location, the North Canteen. We are not very excited because we are so full. Those of you who watched the previous episodes already, you know that at the end, the energy is gone. But okay, no. Let's amp it up a bit.
Yes.
Energy up! So we got Mala at the last location. It was pretty hard to find because it's just a little booth. Waffles as well, it's just a side stall. We got the
Oreo
chocolate as well as the
butter maple syrup.
Really?
Oh my god, it's spicy.
Wow, the potato noodles are amazing. They don't come apart, right? No?
Yeah,
it's very chewy. Yeah, it soaks up all the flavor of the soup. And this one, surprisingly, is not too spicy, the Mala.
It stinks at first, but it's very tasty.
I think, to whoever suggested the potato noodles, thank you. It's really amazing. And now, to all of you out there, sending y'all some love through a cheese tofu.
They both taste the same.
There's no cheese, right? Mm. So now we're gonna go for the butter maple waffle. Can you show them the back, how greasy this is? Oh, it smells really good though.
It's after about to bite.
He put his nose on it, then go faster bite.
Oh my god, it's a good mixture.
Obviously, you go to McDonald's, you order pancakes, butter and maple syrup. It's so good. It's such a homely taste. Right?
Yeah. It's like your mom made it.
This is a breakfast that I want to wake up to every day. And now, on to the chocolatey Oreo. This one is interesting. First, the Oreo, the crushed Oreos add a lot of texture. A very different texture, right?
I don't like it. The child experiments on. Like a child made.
What was your favorite dish throughout this whole experience?
The bingsu.
I thought nothing can beat Halo Halo, the Pinoy version.
Yeah.
That one is very tasty also. But then the bingsu was very simple. It's just shaved ice.
I think my favorite dish would have to be... I mean, since you already chose bingsu as your favorite, I think the closest runner-up would have to be the chili crab pasta. It's a flavor that you can't really find elsewhere for that kind of price. So thanks, Julian, for joining us today. I hope you enjoyed and learned a bit something new about Singapore culture.
A lot. I learned a lot.
Is it?
I'm very confused with the educational system in Singapore.
Basically, for us, after high school, we will either split into JC or polytechnics. Mm. Polytechnics is the same as your college, but it's 3 years.
For
JC, it's 2 years.
And after that,
Oh, yeah. That's a lot of schooling.
Yeah, it is actually. It's one extra step. Okay, so back to work. Back to the Philippines.
I fixed the lighting.
Okay, so thanks so much for following us on this journey. We finally completed the Poly Food Hunt for you guys. I think this series has been quite a success. So we're definitely looking to do a season 2. This time we're going to be heading to universities, right? So the thing is that we don't just want to focus on food. We want to include other fun elements for you guys as well. So let us know in the comments down below. Give us some suggestions on things that we can do to add to this series. If you want to know more about some TSL peeps, if you want to, I don't know more about the schools, let us know in the comments, okay? I'll catch you guys in season 2. So don't forget to like, share, subscribe, check out other videos over here. And until then, bye!